Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm sure you've seen this iconic poster by Shepard Fairey, which became recognized worldwide during Barack Obama's 2008 presidential campaign. Politics aside, this is a great-looking poster, and I'm going to show you how to recreate it using a different headshot. This document is 1,000 by 1,515 pixels with a resolution of 72 pixels per inch. Once you have your headshot file on your screen, you need to cut it out from its background and bring the cutout into your Hope Poster PSD file. Your photo could be black and white or color. For this example, I'll use the Quick Selection tool with a radius of 4 pixels. I'll click and drag around the head. To remove parts of the selection, press Alt or Option first. Invert the selection by pressing Ctrl-Shift-I or Command-Shift-I on a Mac. Press Ctrl or Command plus J to cut the selection from the image and copy it to its own layer. Call up your Move tool. Hold Shift and click on the headshot. Drag it onto the tab of your Hope poster file, and without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down onto the poster. Hide the poster by clicking off its eyeball. Go to Filter, Artistic, and Cutout. The Cutout window will open. This filter simplifies the photo with its Edge Simplicity and Edge Fidelity features. We'll use 5 levels because the poster has 5 colors. Make the Edge Simplicity 5 and the Edge Fidelity 1. Click on the Adjustment Layer icon and choose Channel Mixer. Check Monochrome, which makes all the channels neutral gray. If your photo is already black and white, it's still a good step to use since there may be a subtle color cast to it. Click back on the adjustment panel and choose Posterize. Change the levels from 4 to 5. Click back on the adjustments panel and choose Gradient Map. Click on the gradient and the gradient editor will open. Click on the left stop. This will be our darkest color. Click on the color box and type in 00324D. Click OK and then click below the gradient bar. This creates a new stop. Click on the color box and type in E01825. In location, type in 25%. Click under the bar in the middle and click on the color box. For this color, type in 7498A4. Make another stop. Click on the box and type in FDE5A9. Click on the last stop and make sure it has the same color as the one to its left. Click on the middle box and type in 50% for the location. Click on this color and type in 75%. Hide all the adjustment layers by clicking off their eyeballs and make sure your head cutout is active. We're going to make the second lightest part of your portrait have this line pattern in it. Call up your magic wand tool with a 4 pixel radius. Make the tolerance 10. Click on the second lightest tone and this will make a selection of it. Click on the new layer icon and this will make a new layer. Hover your cursor between this layer and the cutout head. Press and hold Alt or Option. When you see the overlapping circle symbol, click down. Click on the layer mask icon and this makes a layer mask of the selection next to the empty layer. Make all the adjustment layers visible again, and then click on the empty layer to make it active. Click on the foreground color, and type in 50% for brightness. Press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill the layer with 50% gray. Go to Filter, Sketch, and Halftone Pattern. The Halftone Pattern window will open. Choose 1 for the size and 50 for the contrast, and the pattern type is line. The layer is now filled with the line pattern, which is revealed through the layer mask. Press Alt or Option as you click on the eyeball of the Hope poster. This will make just the poster visible while hiding all other layers. Let's make the light border that surrounds the entire poster. Call up your rectangular marquee tool and click on the inside corner of the border. Drag out a rectangle to the opposite inside corner. Press Q to make the selection into a quick mask, and drag out another rectangle to the bottom of the shirt and tie. Press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill it, and Q to make the quick mask back into a selection. Click on the eyeball of your photo to make it visible. Press I to call up your eyedropper tool and click on the darkest tone of your photo. Then fill the selection with that tone. Hide the whole poster and click back on the eyeballs of all the other layers. Make the whole poster active and click on the new layer icon. In this layer, we'll make the blue and red background behind the head. Click on the foreground color and type in 50% for the brightness. Now drag a rectangle over the top left of the poster and fill the selection with the 50% gray. Now delete the selection. Notice the gray is actually the same color as the third color in the poster. This is because this color is assigned the 50% location in the gradient adjustment layer. Now drag a rectangle over the right side. Click on the foreground color and this time type in 25% for brightness. Fill it with that value and delete the selection. It's red because 25% gray is assigned that color by the gradient adjustment layer. We're ready to set the text. Make the whole poster visible. Call up your type tool and click on the character text box. I'm using a font called Nevis Bold, which you can download for free at 10by20.com. The actual font used in the whole poster is called Gotham, but it's not free to download. Click on the color box, click on a letter, and then click OK. Scroll up and click on the top layer to make it active. This will place the text above it. Click on your document and type out your text. Call up your Move tool to reposition it. In the Layers panel, you can make all the layers visible and hide the whole poster. To move the text to the left a bit, I'll click on the left arrow key a few times. To move it down, I'll click on the down arrow a few times. I want to clean up some areas of our poster. The quickest way is to make a composite snapshot. Press Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Magnify it up and click on the foreground color. Click on the color you want to retouch and click OK. Call up your pencil tool and paint over the areas you want to clean up. Have fun making your own iconic poster based on the Hope poster made famous in 2008. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.